Hey guys, it's Brooke here, and I am, I'm at Longwood again, because it is the spring blooms are blooming, and apparently everybody else had the same idea today, so I am in the literal nosebleed section. Like, I'm so far away, they actually have buses to take us to the park, so, let me get in here. I was gonna bring my jacket, but to be quite honest, I don't think I'm gonna be here that long because I want to go antiquing. So that's the beauty of having membership, is I can come over here as much as I want. So anyway, I'll check in with you guys as soon as I get over to the main.
Hey guys, first things first, let's look at all these beds. I don't know if I even took video in the last time I was here because there was nothing to see. Next year, I need to plant a lot more bulbs. This is very nice. Having membership, because you just hand them your little member ID. Hold on a second, there we go. Hand them your member ID, and then you just keep walking. So, let's look at the delphinium. Okay, so this is. Here are the delphiniums that are getting ready to bloom. Some pansy. And I guess that orange thing is quince. Okay, So here we are in the long walk. Okay, so the hyacinth that is Gypsy Queen. Hyacinths. Let's go in the section back here. See some bleeding heart. Ooh, and look at all those peonies, guys. Look at the peonies. That is going to be absolutely beautiful when it starts blooming. Let me see if they actually label these peonies. Look at the size of these things. All of these are absolutely massive. Okay, so this right here is Coral Charm. Okay, I'm so glad I got membership because I'm definitely gonna be coming back in a few weeks to see this. I think in a couple of weeks this will definitely all be blooming. It's really interesting because it seems like they use leaf mulch. They also have June Rose Peony. Okay. They have Hybrid Peony Garden Treasure. Huh. Okay, guys, so in a few weeks, we will be doing a peony tour of Longwood. Candle. this looks so dramatically different from just a couple of weeks ago. The meadow garden, they have mowed it. This is probably gonna be the only time they mow it this year, I would imagine. There's a lot of people out there. I don't know if you can see those little pinpricks, but moving pinpricks, those are people. Thank you. things right here. I want to say that this is referred to as a cupcake farm. There are actually a bunch of, there are actually names for all the forms. You know what? I think the last time I came, this, I think this section might have been closed off. Ooh, look at that. Let's go see. Are these lupine? Oh, these are lupine. Look at that. Love the color on that one. Yeah, you know what? I think this section was closed the first time I came because it was right off the rose garden. Okay, lupine is something I definitely need to add more of to the garden. Wow. This looks so weird with all the roses down. Now that's interesting right there. They whack their roses back to like 15 inches. Huh. I wonder, is it too late for me to do that with mine? So this type of lupine is called masterpiece. Ooh, hang on for a second. Let's look at this trellis. This is Florentina. Oh, I see how they did that. Now that's an interesting idea. Okay, so basically they just got three of these, put them together, tied it at this top, and let's see, they just wind it around. I'm trying to see if any of these branches are overlapping. They don't look like they're overlapping. Huh. Okay, well that's a cheap enough trellis, because I have a bunch of climbing roses and I was trying to figure out how to trellis them, but I just gotta find some of those long metal stakes. Yeah, so I'll try to see if I can find some metal, long metal rods with balls at top, on top of it. That would be really nice.
Yeah, that's what I was checking out.
Thank you.
So I don't know if you guys can see me, but I'm gonna go home now. I'm gonna hit some antique shops on the way, but I'm gonna go to the gift store because I wanted to see what they had. They have these memory keepsake ornaments that are in the shape of a egg that I want to get because you fill them with stuff. So I thought it would be kind of cool. So that is pretty much it. So I hope you enjoyed this tour of the daffodils and tulips. The concluding remarks I can make is I need more tulips and I need more daffodils because that was really, really nice. I definitely wouldn't jam pack them in the beds as tight as all that because basically they pull theirs out and then plant something else, and obviously I'm not going to do that, but I definitely could stand to put in a lot more tulips and daffodils. So I'll see you guys later.